Hey plant friends, welcome back to my channel. It's Mai here. So in today's video, I am finally able to show you guys all the plants that I bought myself and family members have gotten me for passing my exam. Let's just get into the video. First plant that I got myself, also, I say also a lot because I usually don't tell you guys everything up front. You know, I don't want to scare you. But side note, some of these plants, right? Some of these, one plant, some of these plants are duplicates, and all I gotta say is oops, life happens. Sometimes you get greedy and you just want like a bigger version of a plant. So the first plant that I got myself is this plant. It's a Hoya Matilda. Now, I know, I already have one of these. I bought one from a local seller, and then I also traded with my plant friend, James, and then I saw this guy. And it was advertised as a very splashy Matilda, and the ones that I have kind of have splash, but you know, sometimes you want more splash. It doesn't have as much splash as I thought it would, but you know what? It is what it is. I got the plant. It's also a lot different from my other Matilda as well, because the leaves are a bit fatter and a little bit thicker, which it also has some new growth points on it, so I'm really excited about that. But this was my first purchase to myself, from myself, for passing my exam. The next plant that I got myself is a cutting. This is a Hoya Rosita, something like that. I am bad at pronouncing names. Like, I'm bad at pronouncing like people's names, but if you have a dog's name, I'll definitely remember your dog's name. It is a cross between Hoya Weyerii and Hoya DS70. If you've never seen this plant before, Google it. It's beautiful, especially when it's exposed to a lot of sun. I was actually going to buy this from overseas before the whole pandemic occurred, and then I couldn't, and there was someone selling this, so I was like, hey, can I buy a cutting from it? This is a really expensive cutting, it wasn't rooted. It came in with sphagnum moss in this cup, so I'm gonna keep it in this cup and see how it goes. Yeah, it's a pretty long cutting, but expensive cutting. I really like this because of the dark borders, and the new growth can come out really red looking. And some of you guys know I'm obsessed with sun-stressed Hoyas right now, or like they also call it sun-blushed Hoyas. Also, all of these plants, eventually I am going to or have placed them in Leca. Just a heads up there. The next plant that I received was kind of a mistake. A good mistake, a bad mistake for some, but this is my next plant. It is a Hoya Croniana. Croniana, yeah, we're gonna go with that. So it's a Hoya Croniana Eskimo. It's not the super Eskimo, it's the regular one. If you guys have no clue what I'm talking about, definitely Google this plant. It's really cool, but there are like different versions of this plant. This one is just called the Eskimo. I originally wanted the Hoya Croniana Black. If you've never seen that, definitely Google that. It's such a cool gothic plant. Oh, it's just so cool. But the leaves grow, it's kind of like a ZZ Raven in the fact that it grows out green and then it eventually fades to black, or like dark color. One of my lovely viewers sent me an eBay link to an auction of it, but it got really, really expensive. Like, some people, I swear, you guys have like unlimited funds, because it went really high, and I'm just too poor for that. I settled with this one instead. Does have new growth right here, which is really cool. The root system was like top notch. It was so thick. Now we're on to the mistake. So I purchased myself that, and I told my family members about this plant. I've been talking their ear off about it. And so one of my family members decided to very graciously find me a cutting of this Hoya Croniana Eskimo, and here she is. I ordered that large plant and forgot to tell my family member, hey, I already have it. They ordered this for me, it arrived at my house, and I was like, cool. I'm not gonna say no to a free plant, especially a cool plant like this. So I got a clipping of a Hoya Croniana Eskimo, another one. This one was just a cutting. I placed it into Leca. Once this fully grows roots, I'm going to plant this bad boy into this, and yeah. That's all I gotta say for that, folks. It's a pleasant mistake. I'm not mad at all about this. How can you be mad at getting a free plant, right? You can't, unless it comes dead, but then again, it was free. It doesn't matter, right? Next plant I also got myself, this next plant I got off of Etsy, and I was lucky enough to snag this one. Some of you guys are probably laughing like, really, Maya, really? Yes, you guys, yes, this thing's freaking adorable. It is called Sequoia Species GPS 7240 is the name of this Hoya. Yeah, it's a special one, GPS. It just has really cute, short, and kind of stubby and fat leaves. I did see someone on Instagram have this, and I think theirs was like a darker color. I'm not sure if that's because they gave theirs more sun. I just received this, so I'm just gonna test that. I'm gonna give this as much indirect sunlight as I can. It also has some splashing on the leaves as well, which is really interesting. The next Hoya has a very interesting backstory, which you know I'm gonna tell you. This is my Hoya Rebecca. I finally found a local seller who had this Hoya Rebecca and snagged it as fast as I could. Now, if you guys don't know the backstory to this, I did order this from overseas before the whole pandemic occurred, and the seller sent my package off, and I was the last person that they sent the package off with. Well, sad story. That package was stuck up in New York for, I think, 2 months. Or a month, 2 months, something like that, really long time. And it arrived to me, I think, last month, and it was dead on arrival. It was just really limp, black, it was horrible. I did contact the seller, and the seller said that they were gonna send me out a new one once like the postal service in their country is open again. And I'm like, okay, that's fine. I'm very impatient, obviously, because I have a plant that's coming to me, and then I found this locally, and I'm like, I have to have it. So I'm gonna soon have two of these. Why? Because I'm a hoarder, you guys. That's why. Because I'm a hoarder. So yeah, that's the story about this guy. I got greedy. I found it locally, and I'm like, heck to the yes. There's not much to say about this plant, except it does get sun stress. If you give it a lot of light, it turns into like this purple blush color, I guess you can call it. But when I saw this picture online, for some reason I thought it was kind of going to be exactly like the Hoya Sunrise, but in fact it does not look anything like it. The leaves are a lot smaller. So Hoya Rebecca is a cross between Hoya lacunosa Langowy Island and Hoya Obscura. And the Hoya Sunrise has Hoya Obscura as one of the plant parents. I'm not sure what the other parent is for the Hoya Sunrise. But yeah, so that's why this gets sun stress, because of the genes from the Hoya Obscura, which is, you guys know, I freaking love sun stress stuff. The next on my list after this, I guess, is a Hoya Obscura, right? If you guys have one, can you guys comment down below? And if you guys want to plant trade, can you let me know if you have a Hoya Obscura? And let me know what you guys would want to trade for it. Please. Thank you. So yeah, that's my plant that I also got myself. It was very expensive. Yeah. That's all I can say about that. And that's all I'm willing to say about that. Moving on. Next is a plant that I got from one of my family members. It's two plants now. It's two plants now, but it was one plant, but it was quite a large plant. I think it was in like an 8-inch like grower's pot, and you guys will be shocked to see what it is. This is a Hoya Curtisii? Hoya Curtisii. I've been pronouncing this wrong my whole life. Obviously, like a lot of other things. But yeah, I used to call this Hoya Curtisii, but it's Curtisii, because I forgot that there's an extra I. I used to see this all the time at like hardware stores, and I never got it, obviously. And then I found out that this can get sun stress. when you give this a lot of sun, the back of the leaves turns a really dark purple, and also the silver markings in the front of the leaves get more silver. Also, the vines get really thick and woody. It just is very beautiful when it's sun-stressed. But yeah, she is beautiful. Please ignore all of this. Please, please ignore all of this. Just ignore it, okay? Just pretend it's not there. I know for a fact my mom's watching this and she's like cringing right now. I'm probably gonna get a phone call after this and she's gonna probably ask me why I haven't cleaned up. Life, mom, life. That's why. Yeah, this is a lovely guy and you guys are gonna be so surprised what I'm about to tell you next. I transferred her into Lekka. Oh my God. Almost ended really badly. Yeah. She's in Lekka. I transferred her into Lekka Balls. Lekka, Lekka, Lekka Balls. Lekka Balls. Yes. I just have to first and foremost say that I highly do not recommend this at all. Do not transplant your Hoya curtisii into Lekka unless you want to waste 5 hours of your life that you're never going to get back. And you may or may not have a success story afterwards. But this guy, yeah, I got him. He had really wet soil and his leaves were turning yellow, so it made me nervous. So I was like, you know what? This is the time to do it. This Hoya is different from most of the Hoyas I have because he's what I would call a creeper. He likes to crawl on top of the soil, like he branches out that way, kind of like a peperomia beetle, where it just has offshoots off of one stem and then more leaves get produced. And it doesn't have a very deep root system at all because it likes to creep on the top of the soil. So that's why transplanting this into Lekka, it was a lot. Because this plant was so large and because of the way that it grew, I couldn't shove all of the plant in this one pot. So like the theme of all my other videos, duplicates, I now have a second pot of it. She is in Lekka as well. Yes, she is in Lekka. Yeah. What can I say? I couldn't shove it all in one pot and I couldn't increase the pot size because the root system wasn't big enough and I don't have like a short but large pot that I could place this in. So this was my only other option. Okay, now my last plant is not a Hoya, but I did get it from my spouse and yeah, let me just show you what it is. This is a Peperomia prostrata, yes. And it's really sweet that he went out and like bought this plant for me thinking that I really liked it. It's really full. I don't know how much he paid for it. That's the scary thing. He doesn't remember how much he paid for it, which I mean, that's normal. He never looks at price tags at anything, which makes me really nervous. But yeah, it's just really sweet. It's so full too. And I feel like it's such a waste that I have it because I don't want it. I know my older sister is not gonna want this either. I might put this on sale on my Instagram. So if you guys are local and you guys are interested in this, please go to my Instagram and look out for any stories. I might, like I said, place this on there for sale. There is no way in Middle Earth that I would ever pack this up and ship it to anybody because this, no, mm-mm. Too sensitive, such a diva. But if you guys live locally and you guys are interested in this, follow me on Instagram. But yeah, it's cute. It's thick. It is very thick. She's very high. She's very tall and wide at the same time. I don't even know where her soil begins. But yeah, Peperomia prostrata. It's cute, but not for me. So I think that's it. Those are all the plants that I bought myself and got from my loved ones for passing my exam. That's pretty much it, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys are excited for me for all the Hoyas that I have acquired. As always, please hug and kiss your dogs for me, and I'll definitely see you in my next video. Bye, guys.